Today I'm going to discuss about the traditional knowledge ecosystem and its implications in the ecosystem restoration and biodiversity conservation. In a other way that is mentioned, long means around 3,000 years back, may the earth pour out her milk for me as a mother does to her son. I'm not going to read all the things, but here I want to say that even before 3,000 years back, we know that what is the role of the Mother Earth and the Heaven Father to the mankind, and we must respect the Mother Earth as a mother. So the cosmic tree that the man who worships every day, the aswath means people, the ficus logica tree, is regarded as the worship the whole universe with the gods and demons and the human beings. Here, see the beauty that the people tree is regarded as the miniature symbol of the universe. And as we all know that the ethnic communities have inherited the rich tradition of the love and reverence for the nature through the ages. And it is reflected in their religious preaching, traditions, custom, taboos, totems, and all that. And they all play a big role in protecting the nature environment. And actually, they are the advocates of the environmentalism. And they have specific guidelines, which is ensure the intimate contact and the sense of belonging in the natures. And today, the world is undergoing a serious crisis of ecological imbalance and environmental degradation. It is all the more important for us to understand the such tradition so that we can protect our Mother Earth. See, the development, degradation, and deterioration is going parallel each other. And this is all because of the development, indiscriminate development, and the over-exploitation of the natural resources by the human being. The most intelligent animal on this earth, the human being, they are actually creating the problem. So we know that tribal communities and the ethnic communities of the India, specifically India, they are nature worshippers. And for them, the forest, the rock, the river, the mountain, the tree, they all are sacred to them. And they believe in the spirit that live in the nature and natural surroundings and may be benevolent and the malevolent for their life and livelihood. And the quantum of the importance given to the environment is not limited. They have given the environment as to the status of a god and as they worship the natural habitat. They even protect the environment, considering it as their responsibility towards their ancestors, because they believe that their ancestors live in the nature and they reside in the natural objects present around them. So the tribal communities and the ethnic communities conserve and preserve their environment through the traditional knowledge and the wisdom. And this knowledge has been accumulated through a long way of observation, natural resource use practices, and transmission over the generations. And India is the land of diversity, we all know, and it is a varied culture and ecological landscape being embedded in the rich traditional wisdom. Indigenous people had depended on, for the long period, on the local environment for the provisions of a variety of the resources. The problem arises when these variety of the resources will get over-exploited. And due to so, may call the industrial revolution and all that. But because of that, this the local environment, it has started degrading. But still they have developed a stake of conserving and in some cases enhancing the biodiversity system. And they were aware of the biological diversity as a crucial factor in generating the ecological services and the natural resources on which they are dependent. So they have close intimacy between the environment, ecosystem, and the society. So these traditional knowledge we must protect. So there is a need and need for the partnership between the indigenous and local knowledge and the current science. So this amalgamation means coexistence for the sarva, means for protecting the nature and the environment, is required as a need of the hour. See, we know that this human social systems and the ecosystems, they both are adaptive to ecosystems, and they are very complex in nature. And they are complex because they have many connections between the different parts, and they are adaptive as they have the structure to promote the survival in the constantly with the changing environment. So due to this adaptiveness, these systems become very complex. and in order to analyze these environmental and human interaction, it is very important to aware the specific characteristic of the human social systems. And a society strongly influences the people's attitudes toward the nature, their behavior, and therefore in turn impact on the ecosystems. The important characteristics of the human social systems are population size, social organization, values, technology, wealth, education, knowledge, and many more. And these values and knowledge strongly influence the people's view of life and consequently define the way the people act. So, and ecology is the science of relationship between the living organisms and the environment we know. And human ecology is about the relationship between the people and the environment. So this human, the role of human is very crucial in this area. And ecosystem, everything is specific. The area is specific, the air is specific, soil, water, living organism, physical characters, and everything which is built by the human being, they are all included. And the living part of the ecosystems, microorganisms are there, plants are there, animals are there, biological communities are there. So this social system is the central concept in the human ecology. Why I'm telling the human ecology? Because everything, whatever the degradation or the deterioration or the problem we are facing in terms of the water, air, soil, plastic, wildlife, biodiversity, pollution, climate change, and many more, they all are because of the anthropogenic factor, that is human. So human ecology is because human activities that impact on the ecosystems are strongly influenced by the society in which the people live. So here the human social values are also important. Now, due to the strong urbanization and the modern way of lifestyle, we are leaving behind our traditions. And that is another main cause for the deterioration of the environment. So here is it is a need of our to go back to our traditional social system as far as the environment is concerned. And this environmental degradation, see, this is a process which is reducing the biodiversity, biological diversity, reducing the health of the environment. And to heal the health of the environment, because this is an ecosystem, something natural in an origin, and this is accelerated, retarded, or influenced by the human activities. So in the core, in the center, it is a human. So it is the human who has to decide about the environment. And as a human intelligent animal, we are actually just try to get just a benefit out of everything, whether this is beneficial to the human being or not, whether this will generate money or not, whether this will. So the development which we are claiming is a development, rather it is a development or this is a degradation. So this is the time to think about. And see, human like other organisms on the earth interact one way or another way with the biotic and abiotic factors in the environment. And this environmental degradation occurs when a renewable resource, whether it's a abiotic or biotic, needs and uses natural resources. And this overexploitation of the natural resources is the cause for the environmental biodegradation. And pollution is another problem. Pollution is all man-made pollution. There is no animal, means even the forest burning when it is created and lot of carbon dioxide is released in the environment, that our carbon dioxide is required for the plants. So that is a natural phenomena. And ecosystem is having tendency to balance such natural activities such as the forest fires and all that. But the pollution created by the human being, that is very, how to conserve the environment. Everybody is talking about the sustainable use and the management of the natural resources, which include the wildlife, water, earth, soil, and all that. And conservation of the natural resources focuses on the needs and interests of the human beings. For instance, the biological, economical, and cultural needs. So how to make the balance between these two? So for that, many case studies has been taken up by many people. And see, the conservation through the traditional knowledge or traditional ecosystem knowledge and the wisdom, it is having many references in the Indian system. And in Indian beliefs and practices, it is a part and partial of the day-to-day life. And they know how to maintain the environment and how to make the sustainable use of the environment. So now this is a need to make the need and the benefit of the research partnership between the indigenous local knowledge and the science is the need of the hour. And this knowledge will be helpful in decision making, because environmental science relying on a strict epistemological method to produce the universal knowledge, but has no opportunity to sufficiently detail operation of the nature across the spatial scale. So to meet the need for the spatial across the spatial scale, we have to go back to the tradition, and we have to explore the totemism and the totem and the taboos, beliefs and practices used by the traditional people as a socio-economical, ecological complexity, environmental solutions. So this present day scientist contest constantly progressing, but this science is suffering from the limited information biases of the efforts, especially spatial, temporal, and the taxonomical biases. So the inclusion of the traditional and the local knowledge is the need of the hour in decision and policy making for the proper implementation through the collaborative research. See, addressing the challenge and the tension between the ecological sciences, traditional knowledge, and the decision making. So this is actually long standing past and ongoing tensions. You have to make the difference between the long-standing problems, past problems, and the ongoing tensions, and identifying the positive examples to overcome the problems. And these challenges and tension can be addressed through the traditional knowledge exploration. An important thing is that you have to trust and equitably in the relationship to you have to go for the two-eyed seeing. Means you have to see at the two sides, that means multiple way of viewing. You cannot concentrate only on the science to get the solution for the day-to-day problem related to the environmental depletion. So linking the multiple knowledge system to the action to have the credibility, salience, and legitimacy. So this all will three together will make a proper system. And this system will may ensure the participation of the all the knowledge systems, all the information available from the past, present, and maybe future, all the management practices which we are using from the past till date, and all the decisions we have already taken related to the environment and which we are going to take, means make the policies. So these are all the multi-skill relationships are there. And this is the need of the hour. And this can be achieved through the co-assessment, co-production, and biocultural conservations. So this is the thing we have to, and if you go for this, then only we can see in 1992, when the Rio de Janeiro, Agenda 21, Chapter 26, they talked about the indigenous knowledge system and we have to conserve it. So that is actually today's theme, means that the 5th June theme, World Environmental Day theme, ecosystem restoration, reimagining, recreate, and restore. I'm sorry to say the present modern day science do not have any specific solution for these problems. For the reimaging, recreation, and restoration, you have to go back to the traditions. How the people of the past were used to treat the local environmental problems. And these problems, which are, it cannot be claimed as a global problem. It's not a global problem. All the problems related to ecosystems are the local ecosystem problems only. And they have the local ecosystem solutions also. You have to adopt the traditional knowledge for that to resolving the tension created by the system of that specific area. And if you just concentrate on the specific small areas, small ecosystems, then automatically the overall scenario will be getting better. So you can see the sacred groups are there. And in the Tamil Nadu, this is a scene from the Madurai region where the robotic horses are just placed in the sacred group area. So now this is the deeper partnership between the indigenous knowledge holders and science is required to address the multifaceted issues facing the conserved areas and those experience the environmental changes and want to restore it. There are some terms, I will escape it. I know that we are having some time constraints. So this is the important thing, that the forms and information, the knowledge, I mean, how we can achieve this. So there are the 4 points, means evidence-based. What are the synthesis of the natural science evidences that are available, designed and built by the scientist, normally focusing on the linear chains of the causation. Co-assessment means sequential synthesis of the evidences, first from the scientific body of the knowledge, and then involving the indigenous and the local knowledge at the later stage, led primarily by the scientists, because local knowledge holders, they have the knowledge, but they don't. They are not able to explain it, and they are not able to prepare a proper system for it. They have the system, but they don't have the explanation for it. So this is the co-assessment is required with the help of the scientist, sequential synthesis of the evidences. Then co-production, the parties from the different knowledge systems collaboratively design research and knowledge synthesis and create the outputs. And the last form of the information is a bioculture conservation, an integrative approach to address and loss of culture and biological diversity and need of the multiple rights holders and stakeholders with the multiple objectives. So culture, practice, knowledge, and information are viewed interactively, and the multiple epistemologies are embrace the multifaceted research. So this is a thing. You see, at one agenda side, you have to go for the knowledge. Knowledge is from the scientists from the left. Knowledge is from the indigenous people and knowledge holders from the right. And this all knowledge you have to go from the evidence base. Then you have to go for the co-assessment, co-production, bioculture. Then only you have an integrative social ecological focus and ecological focus or solution for the environment. So we know that we are facing challenges are there, and we are facing the declining ecosystem services, due to multitude threat created by the unprecedented growth in consumerism and development. And the human domination of the earth is evident in the global change, biodiversity extinction, and disruption of the ecosystem functions. And these ecological problems are coupled with the unequal access of the natural resources, results in the human ill-being and threats to the livelihood security of the world poorest. The problem is, again, I will say the same thing, that we, the human being, we are highly selfish people. We are just thinking about ourselves. When we are getting less oxygen, we are just getting aware of the trees. And you just go back to the tradition, and you can see that they have the self sufficiency.
Sorry to interrupt you. You have 5 more minutes.
Okay, I'm just going to conclude it. I will escape many things and I will just come to this. So this is the thing. See, you have to integrate the social, socio-ecological and economical, anthropological, all the paradigms to the single phase. And now see, the important is that now we don't have the pure traditional knowledges are not available. Now the traditional knowledges are hybridized, and new knowledges from the urban sources, project markets, and other knowledge sources are also there. And they are reflecting on our day-to-day life. And see, another problem is that the most of the ecological traditional knowledge is going waste. Means we are not able to make use of the resources which are available with the smallholders, including ethnic minorities, and we are not able to manage the forest properly. So now the scientists are reaching the forest and they are doing the work. This is the framework how we can achieve. Within 2 minutes. You have to identify the resources and the environment which is having some problem. You have to define these resource qualities and characters of that resources. You have to study the resources, uses, practices, constraints, and opportunities along with the traditional knowledge. You have to describe the resource transformation process, and then you have to create a model in decision-making processes and system-level regulators. At what system level, which regulators should be applied. And then you have a model resource dynamics process regulators, means which is amalgamation of all the systems. And then you have to develop the element of the improved resource use practice and test and develop the improved management practice. So this is a chart which is a need of the hour, including the socioeconomic research, traditional knowledge, all the knowledge systems, not only traditional, and the science. See, you have to integrate the Western knowledge system with the modern knowledge system. Indigenous knowledge is having qualitative approach, whereas the scientific knowledge is having quantitative. It is intuitive, rational, holistic, justness, moral, spiritual, and value-free. It is a mind and matter together. They consider it as a mechanistic approach. Here it is an empirical observation. This is based on the experimentation and the systemization. This is generated and held by the users themselves. This is generated by the specialist and the scientist. This is a dichronic, means long time series of the information on a specific locality. And this is a synchronic, means with a short time series over a large area. So you have to make use of both these two. You have to merge these two. And this, that can be possible with the, you have to go for the different perspective, scientific, skepticism, and the policies making. Then only you can go for it. So I'm going to conclude this. Indigenous knowledge, environment, biodiversity are complementary phenomena essential to the human development. The current scale of the ecosystem degradation underscores a need for the restoration intervention. It is increasingly recognized that the successful ecological restoration depends on the effective coordination of the science and the traditional ecological knowledge. And the main contributions of the traditional knowledge to the environmental restorations are the construction of the reference ecosystem, particularly when the historical information is not available, the species selection, site selection for the restoration, knowledge about the historical land management practices, management of the invasive species, and the post-restoration monitoring. So this is all about, with the request to save plant, save yourself, save earth. Thank you very much.